Tuesday. I'm looking tired and feeling quite sick. I felt like there was something missing in my day-to-day life. So I quickly opened the wardrobe, pulled out some jeans and a t-shirt that seemed clean. Topped it off with a pair of old shoes that were ripped around the seams. And I thought these shoes just don't suit me. Hey, I put some new shoes on and suddenly everything's right. I said, I put some new shoes on and everybody's smiling, it's so inviting. Oh, short on money but long on time, slowly strolling in the sweet sunshine. And I'm running late and I don't need an excuse, so I'm wearing my brand new shoes. Hey, I put some new shoes on and suddenly everything is right. I said, hey, I put some new shoes on and everybody's smiling, it's so inviting. Oh, short on money but long on time, slowly strolling in the sweet sunshine. And I'm running late and I don't need an excuse, so wearing my brand new shoes. Oh, hey, I put some new shoes on and suddenly everything is right. I said, hey, I put some new shoes on and everybody's smiling, it's so inviting. Excuse, 'cause I'm wearing my brand new shoes.
When you came to me with your bad dreams and your fears, easy to see you've been crying. Seems like everywhere you turn, catastrophe reigns. Who really profits from the dying? I could hold you in my arms.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Anne Wall, and I would like to welcome each and every one of you here today to join with Mark and Elaine in the solemnization of their marriage.
I could hold you in my arms. Oh, I could hold you forever.
I love you not only for what you have made of yourself, but for what you are making of me. I love you for the part of me that you bring out. I love you for putting your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over all the foolish weak things.
And be one traveller, long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth.
So, Elaine and Mark have chosen a traditional hand fasting ceremony. In Europe, until the mid-1700s, few unions were sanctified in a church or a synagogue. Rather, they were celebrated by a simple hand fasting ceremony, in which the two partners joined hands over the village anvil in the fields or in the groves of trees. Today, we build upon this tradition. The couple linked hands to form an infinity circle, symbolizing the entirety of the universe as represented in their relationship.
Mark, I'll ask you to repeat after me.
I do solemnly.
And sincerely declare.
That I know not.
I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Mark Byrne.
Why I, Mark Byrne.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In matrimony.
In matrimony.
To Elaine O'Callaghan.
To Elaine O'Callaghan.
Elaine.
Ditto.
I do solemnly.
I do solemnly.
And sincerely declare.
And sincerely declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment. Why I, Elaine O'Callaghan.
Why I, Elaine O'Callaghan.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In matrimony.
In matrimony.
To Mark Byrne.
To Mark Byrne.
Mark, do you understand the declaration you have just made?
I do.
And have you made it of your own free will and without duress?
I have.
Are you laughing, Mark? Elaine, do you understand the declaration you have just made?
I do.
And have you made it of your own free will and without duress? Great for people in your day. I call upon
these persons here present
to witness that I, Mark Byrne, do take you, Elaine O'Callaghan,
to be my lawful wedded wife.
Elaine, I call upon
these persons here present
to witness that I, Elaine O'Callaghan,
Do take you, Mark Byrne,
to be my lawful wedded husband. Mark, do you take Elaine to be your wedded wife?
I do.
And will you love her and comfort her through sickness and through health?
I will.
Elaine, do you take Mark to be your wedded husband?
I do.
And will you love him and comfort him through sickness and through health?
I will. In you, I find a home for my heart, my soul, and my joys and my troubles. And this home I can't wait to get back to every day. This home where sitting cuddled up in our uncomfortable couches and my head on your chest feels like the most different thing in the world. I vow to you today to always be your home, to always be there to help you, good times and bad. Put our relationship on the mantle as my most prized possession, to cherish and protect it above all others. I vow to always be your biggest fan and advocate, and know that no matter what life throws at us, as long as I can feel the warmth of your arms holding me at night, I can make this marriage a real success.
That
deserves
a round of applause. Today I pledge myself to you, in words and actions, in all that I do. I promise to be the person you see in me, because you believe in me more than I could have ever believed in myself. You'll always have the best of me. I love, honor, and obey, and nurture our love every day. Today is the first day of the rest of our lives, heaven by my side, with you as my bride. You are my soul, my strength, my life, and today I'm proud to say, finally, my wife.
She's a mystery girl. 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 Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to invite you here today to share in this historic of days. The day that Mark finally admits that I am in fact the better man and therefore the best man.
As a happily married man, I give you two rules of advice, Mark. Rule one, your wife is always right. Rule two, if your wife is wrong, revert to rule one. Wise words indeed.
I can't even understand my own wife, you know, at this stage. I remember when Elaine, she came to me and she said, "Dad, I met a fella." Well, Elaine doesn't talk that way, I do, but, you know, she's more posh. She broke the news to me. She said he was a fierce football fan and he supported Newcastle. Tell you the truth, I was totally dumbstruck. I never met one. But then I thought for a while, I thought Elaine to hold on to him. He used to have knocks in life, you know.
I'd like to say it's undoubtedly an honour to be here to be Mark's best man. I genuinely couldn't reach double figures when I was listing out the places I'd rather be. It was a really, really tough choice. There was a lot of contenders for this best man's role, and you know, he did ask a couple of times. He did ask a couple of people. I know for a fact that the first person he asked was his most witty and charming friend. He said no. He then moved on and asked his most handsome friend. He also said no. Then he moved on to his most intelligent friend, hoping the speech would sparkle and play him up big. He also said no. On the fourth occasion my phone rang, I just said, listen Mark, you've asked me four times, alright, I'll do it.
Hey Mark, Lane, like, I wish you nothing but the best. I wish you happy times, I wish you the best of times, and I wish you a long life together. So I'd like everyone to raise their glasses and a round of applause for the bride and groom. Thank you.
I just want to formally, you know, do the best man thing and invite Elaine to join the family. But it's not something I feel that's even necessary, because Elaine knows at this stage she's more than part of the family.
On behalf of the rest of the family, we love her dearly, and we welcome Mark here and Kelly, and live the rest of your life and have a good life. Thank you.
We've got a little girl here now to my right, who's given her seal of approval, and this little girl only knows one way to tell you how much you mean to her. And if she'd like to take the... Oh, she does. She's up really quick. What would you like to say to Elaine?
Thumbs up, Elaine.